Well, ahead of Friday's National Cabinet, Canberra is pushing the states to unlock the economy, fearing every idle day is causing long-term damage. Labor agrees the country needs to get working, but wants the JobKeeper scheme extended to more casuals. Here's Chris Yuleman.
The Treasurer began his day carpet-bombing the airwaves.
Treasurer, good morning to you.
Nice to be with you, Ali.
Nice to be with you, Fran.
Nice to be with you, Michael.
To amplify the government's call to unlock a national economy bleeding $4 billion a week.
We need to lift these restrictions as soon as possible.
The National Cabinet of Federal, State and Territory leaders meets on Friday to settle on a staged retreat from lockdown, and the Commonwealth is pushing the states hard.
Yes, we follow the medical advice. That has served us well, but so too we need to get people back into work.
Because history has ruled on the damage caused by long-term unemployment.
It's been said that unemployment went up the elevator but came down the stairs.
The longer the unemployment queues get, the harder it will be for our economy and our society to recover.
Labor says more harm is being caused by the government not extending the JobKeeper allowance.
Too many of them have been left out and left behind by the government's decision to exclude casuals and other workers.
The road to recovery will be long, hard and taken in small steps. But what the lockdown has delivered is time to strengthen the nation's health defences.
Because there will be outbreaks.
The actual numbers, we expect that they will rise. That's something we will take into account.
But Australia can't continue to pay the billions needed to hide from the disease.
There is no money tree at the back of the parliamentary garden.
Right now, government cash is the only thing keeping the country afloat. Chris Yuleman, Nine News.